Hello and greetings from the Hampton Roads Church in Virginia. My name is Ed Anton, this is my wife Deb, and together we serve in the campus ministry of this church.
Greetings from Hampton Roads. God has been working powerfully in the Hampton Roads Church, which includes cities from Virginia Beach, Norfolk, Suffolk, Chesapeake, Hampton, Newport News, and other surrounding cities and counties.
Recently, we were able to host an event, the International Leadership Conference. A lot of people from our church worked very hard to make it a great event, and a great event it was. As people came in from all over the place, they were able to enjoy great times of encouragement, fellowship, inspiration, instruction, and more importantly, we were all able to get together face to face and work on the unity of our churches.
I was especially encouraged by the number of women disciples that literally traveled from around the world to come together, encourage each other, build each other up, fight for unity, and to strengthen the women's ministry around the world.
We had a new ministry that was at the event. It's the online ministry of the Hampton Roads Church. They were there with their cameras, with their notepads, with their recorders, and they recorded some of those great moments. We'd like to share them with you now.
It's always been my dream to see ILC organized in Hampton Roads since my first visit to Hampton Roads Church 3 years ago. And because I felt what the whole worldwide brotherhood need to see is a family. And we need to be a family. So I felt that it's so great that we can come together as a family. And I felt this is the best place where we can get a sense of family.
Just being reminded that we are set apart and that we need to be believers of that and really have convictions of that and really stand on the word to have that conviction and have that truth that we are to be set apart from the world and how we're living, how we're leading, how we're encouraging our people and not being afraid to say that and to live that out.
The thing I'm most excited about is just the fact that there are so many leaders here. You know, I think 3 or 4 years ago, it would have been hard. You know, there was a lot of skepticism. But it's great to see that the brotherhood is again uniting. Because where I'm from in Australia, we're hit pretty hard. And so the unity isn't really there the way it needs to be. It's not like what I'm seeing here. And that's what we need to do.
The world is a huge place. And Jesus said, go and make disciples of all nations, not just go and make disciples of your neighborhood. And so I think a conference like this reawakens people to the mission of seeing the world saved and making sure that everybody gets to hear about Jesus. It's just so inspiring to be part of a worldwide brotherhood with this common mission of changing the world one soul at a time for Christ.
So many children in South Africa have lost parents to AIDS, and the numbers just continue to climb. In a country of roughly 48 million, more than 5 million South Africans are infected with HIV. The epidemic has decimated families, leaving hundreds of thousands of children with responsibilities that no child should have to shoulder. Again, here's CNN's Jeff Kainangi.
17-year-old Busi Dlalu is a single mother of one. And like any young mother, struggles with the new challenges of caring for her 7-month-old son. It's always mealtime here in her small shack. It's when little mouths are hungry that Busi feels the weight of the crisis that surrounds her. She is a surrogate mother of 5 orphan siblings. Their mother died of AIDS more than a year ago, leaving a heavily pregnant Busi in charge of a household of hungry mouths, ranging in age from 1 to 15. She's a child raising children.
Yes, I used to cry every day. The hardest thing, when I wake up in the morning, the children come to me. Hey, sis, we are hungry. Oh!
No money for food, clothes, or even medicine. Two of the children are HIV positive. 7-year-old Nelisiwe and 3-year-old Tulani. But as difficult as things may look, there does seem to be a ray of hope in the form of Hope Worldwide, a US-based NGO. Hope Worldwide provides monthly food rations to child-headed households in Soweto, as well as counseling and supervision.
We're really overwhelmed by the issue of child-headed households and the needs of orphans. Right now in South Africa, there are about 5.5 million people that are living with HIV. We have over a million orphans due to HIV. By 2010, we may have 2.5 to 3 million orphans. Probably 1/5 of those will be child-headed households.
Artin Weller says at the end of the day, organizations like Hope Worldwide can only do so much, and that the various communities ravaged by AIDS have to chip in to help save the children. Before that happened, Busi and many like her seemed destined for a life of misery and misfortune as AIDS continues to wreak havoc here, reducing once thriving families into broken down households headed by children.
Searching for God at all? Maybe later on in life.
Yeah, later on. Do you feel like when your friends interact with you, they're like, "That's a woman of God"? Or do you feel like you blend in?
I don't want to say super ultra committed. I'm in church every single day, but what I do is I am in choir at church.
Do you ever read the Bible?
Used to. Kind of read the beginner's Bible, which is kind of a, it just has a bunch of pictures and it's like really badly worded. It's the funniest thing I've ever read.
Does it help you get closer to God?
No.
I should go with my father.
Really? That's cool. Why is that?
Because I'm a Christian. Uh-huh. And I think Christianity is not about religion. It's cool, but it's about a relationship with God.
We're not allowed to show support to anything that contradicts our Torah, and that would include even conservative and reformed Judaism. We can embrace the reformed Jews and the conservative Jews, but if a conservative Judaism program was doing what you're doing, mm-hmm. we wouldn't be able to participate. You know, we're brothers because we're both, you know, created by God, full man, but when it comes to such contrasting views, we have to step back.
He's everywhere. I don't really go to church, so I can't say church.
And they also, you know, they have these Bible talks, I think Wednesdays and Thursdays here on campus, like around 12:30, so if you guys ever wanted to come check it out, that'd be really cool. So how do you feel like on a campus like this? Do you feel like you see Christians around here?
I don't see Christians around here, and it's a topic that people avoid.
Talon Real and Chevy.
The film you are about to see represents a significant breakthrough in the advancing science of the motion picture.
Are you the next Spielberg, Lucas, or Scorsese? Or just someone with a vision to produce an inspiring story? Use your creative talents to produce a video story and submit it to Disciples Today as part of our video contest. You can enter in categories of children's ministry, preteens, teens, campus, singles, marrieds, parenting, seniors, or any topic that inspires, informs, or connects. Winners in the campus category will be shown at the International Campus Ministers Conference in Boston in July. Others will be used in future Disciples Today editions and distributed around the world. Send your DVD or mini-DV tape to Disciples Today, 708 Morris Court, Lombard, Illinois, 60148. Good luck, and we'll see you on the big screen.